collapsing universe, last image on the TV screen rounded to dotness as it shrinks back into infinity. On the other hand, of course, Bart is a fiction, a voice, a character, and yet he wasn't always. I used to know him, and perhaps you did too. Perhaps we all always know everything, everyone. It is, she repeats tiredly, after all, a universe, a one thing happening. We pokings up of self-organized structure marvel at the randy frankness of synchronicity, the hand of the goddess on our backs, the masks on our faces. Who are we this time? Hard CAD lines or weeping watercolor blurs? Where do I stop and where does mommy begin? We must learn separation, says coke addict, warfuck hemisphere, James King voice, glass man, pebbled in a matrix of concrete. I must exist, even if existence means death. The plenum has no face, but it has a voice. And we are at this point, we are at the end of the fiction. I'm sorry you saw that. You shouldn't have seen that. Now I'll have to. But and that's it. There's one bonus for folks who leap outside the system. There is a tool that in those days was used by people creating Macintosh programs called ResEdit. Macintosh, every piece of software had what were called forks, or branches in the software itself. There was the data fork, which had the actual text or images, and then there was a resource fork. And so there was a tool called ResEdit. And ResEdit was a way of opening up a HyperCard stack to look inside the invisible fork in the file. And so it may be that other folks have not found this yet, but inside Egypt, in the resource fork, there are some text resources. There are three of them, 128, 129, and 130. Text resource 128 says, copyright 1992, Emily Keane and Arthur Buddy Newkirk Osiris, and the trustees of Arthur Newkirk. No dedicated mother, no Walker Percy, just a kid I used to know who never had a chance to grow up to be the writer he dreamed of. It's strange how you find yourself replicating your parents' lies despite analysis and insight, as the grooves in the spiral find us, despite ourselves, oscillating between Sphinx and Rainbow. Text resource 129. Copyright, Buddy Newkirk and the Friends of Emily Keane. Nothing's over until we say it's over. Wake up and find that one has, in some chemical fugue state, embedded signatures even unto the resource fork. Aha, madness. Madness at the lights. The wish for the return. But no. Emily is the friend you knew, the first of your charmed circle to fall. The one whom you were sure was faking that this was all some massive charade, cooked up at your expense as you looked down in the casket. At the sewn-up face, the blotted makeup applied all along, you were sure that at any moment those eyes would open, and she would laugh, that laugh, pleased beyond words, as would all the assembled mourners at the success of their long joke. But it was not to be. The next day, you put her in the ground, and went to cry mindlessly and ceaselessly over her sketchbooks and Super 8s, the last remnants of the lost continent. And you thought, perhaps, that by creating, recreating yourself through her, that the memory might somehow become an ally, rather than this dark upwelling of hopelessness. Text resource 130.